Mom's hand. Our school are going to organize a drawing competition. The main topic is gratefulness.
Oh, drawing? Sounds interesting.
In addition, you will have to present about your drawing. A beautiful painting and nice presentation will get the first prize. Remember to participate in it.
Oh, the prize must be very big.
What should I draw?
Why is my mom coming home so late today?
Oh, Mom, why are you coming home late today?
Yesterday my store is very crowded. I had to work extra hours.
Here, I bought you some mandu.
Thank you, Mom.
Mom, what's wrong with your hand?
Oh, never mind, I'm okay. I dropped a cup and hurt myself.
Mom, are you really okay? You need to stay at home.
No, I'm okay. I still can't work. I just need you to be nice and study hard.
Mom, I got a 10. I'm so proud of my son.
Mom, your hand is hurting again. What's wrong with you?
No, I'm still okay. You don't need to worry about me.
Mom, can you go to school with me tomorrow? My school are organizing a drawing competition, and there's my drawing.
Really? So I'll definitely will go there.
Yes, Mom. Thank you, Mom.
Oh, is this a drawing competition?
Yes, Mom.
During the competition, we are proud to realize that there are so many drawing talents in my school. Now I'll read the list of the students that got prizes. The third prize belonged to Hoàng Như Ngọc, 4A.
Mom, don't be sad if my painting does not get any prize.
Son, I won't be sad. I'm proud of being here today. The first prize of this drawing competition belongs to Nguyễn Văn Nam, 5A.
Oh, my son, is that you?
Yes, Mom, it's me.
Nguyễn Văn Nam, please come here to present about your drawing and receive the prize.
Oh, that is a couple of hands.
Yes, my drawing is not about the big things. It is simply a couple of hands. But those hands is very meaningful to me because it's my mom's hands. Those hands fed me and raised me up from when I was born. From when I started my first steps. The hand that lifted me up when I fell. Those hands took care of me carefully. Those hands suffered from hard work just because of me. Gradually, those hands become rougher and not soft like before. But for me, those hands are the most beautiful hands, because it contains a giant love from my mom.
Mom, I just want to tell you a thing that I love you so much and I'm so grateful to you.
Nice, very nice. What a good boy you are.
Teacher, can I invite my mom here to receive the prize with me?
Because I want to give it to my mom.
Sure, kid.
Mom, I love you.
I love you too, my son.
The swans.
Once upon a time, there was a valuable lake in a small palace. You see, it looked like a golden lake.
Those swans are sent here by the god.
They change their fur twice a year and bring a large amount of gold.
They are here for almost 3 years.
My property is unlimited.
There is no place like this in the world.
That's true. Everything you say is correct.
Hey, remember that people can only come here if I allow.
No one dare to come here without your allowance.
Hey, my friends, the king of this land really values us. This place is worthy to live for a long time.
That's right. This lake is beautiful, the atmosphere are comfortable.
We do not have to face with the challenging weather here.
The weather is very cold in the winter, but the king has different methods to keep the lake warm.
And we can eat the most delicious food all over the world.
The life here is so great.
Who are you? Why do you dare to be here?
Do you know that in order to live here, we have to pay back 2 times changing fur a year, which is all golden?
I don't know, but I really want to be in this lake. And I want to stay here. I just need small space.
No, that's impossible.
Can you please lend me just a small space?
I told you, no is no, no, no.
Oh my god, where is that giant golden bird?
What a rare bird.
We need to tell the king in order to discriminate.
The god has bring me a precious golden bird.
Guys, quickly! Put those wands away and keep the golden bird from me.
Guys, I don't want to be treated like this.
The king sacrificed us just because of that giant golden bird.
Guys, let's go, we'll find another lake.
We cannot stand being treated like this.
Never mind, I got that giant golden bird.
Now, this lake will belong to that giant golden bird.
Oh my god, guys, do something.
We cannot let it fly away.
The termite legend.
Once upon a time, there was a young master who is of marriageable age, but he is only into a stunningly beautiful girl, so his parents can't find him a suitable wife. Until his parents passed away, he still could not find a wife.
Dear Emperor, there was a guy on earth who is of marriageable age, but he is so picky, so he could not find a suitable wife. Let me see him.
Come here.
Yes.
You will come to the earth and test whether he can see the real beauty of a person or not. If he cannot see that, give him a lesson.
Yes, Father.
Dear young master, this girl wants to be your servant. And we also like servants. She is nice, hardworking, and flexible. How do you think?
You can decide that.
Yes, sir.
Delicious. From now on, you must cook for me.
Yes, sir. She is so hardworking and skillful.
I wish our master will...
My parents' anniversary is coming, and I don't know who should I trust to prepare the meals for them.
I can't handle that.
But the tables are very big. Can you handle it all?
I promise I can.
Oh, good. Really good.
Wow, I have never eaten such a delicious milk like this.
There is a very skillful servant who prepared all of this for us.
There she is.
She not only cooks well but also handles all the household chores very carefully.
What a nice girl.
But she is too ugly.
I wish you can find a stunningly beautiful wife as you always wanted.
Stay at home and wait for my good news.
Oh, is that you?
She is really beautiful.
Boss, we have a stunningly beautiful fairy in our house, but we didn't know that.
Who is she?
She's the servant.
I was blind.
You're so beautiful, but I didn't know that.
Please be my wife.
I am a fairy and I was sent here by the emperor, but now my time is over.
If only you can realize it earlier, I would not have to.
The emperor has given the young master a worthy lesson, turned him into a termite, always clicking his tongue to regret the day staying with the fairy.